Should men recommend revolvers to women? Is the mystery heater system too difficult to start? And I'm going to do some experiments on the Faraday cage ideas behind the Faraday cage. Can you actually put a cell phone in the microwave and protect it from EMP? Well, I'm going to find out myself. All right. First, in reference to women and revolvers and men recommending revolvers to women. Okay, Mega Winfrey said that, quote, simple answer, revolvers are extremely reliable, so are a lot of automatics, but the visual people see with revolvers is less movement. A revolver you can grab out of the draw and pull the trigger, and almost no training is needed other than point, aim, and squeeze. Person goes on to say that most gunfights inside a home are only 1 to 4 rounds fired at most. I mean, let me put it to you this way. If my life was on the line, and I had to rely on a woman to save my life, or anybody for that matter, I would want her to have a Glock or EMP or some type of semi-automatic that's highly reliable. Okay? This is what I want her to have to save my butt. Okay, that's all I gotta say there. Okay, Ashley Williams commented, quote, you are right, I'm looking to buy my first gun. I'm a female, and every gun store I go to, the clerk always shows me the revolvers. Let me just jump in there. I don't know what they're thinking. Now, salesmen, they sell, okay? It's just like any other store. They may figure, this lady doesn't know anything about guns. Let's try to sell her whatever doesn't sell very well or whatever. Or maybe she's too stupid to handle a semi-auto. Look, like I said, if my life is on the line, I want that woman to have more than just 6 rounds, okay? And trying to reload that thing can be it requires a fine motor skill to actually put that round in there. It's actually easier with a magazine with a semi-auto. You could use a speed loader with your revolver, but still you gotta sort of make sure you put it in just right. Yeah, it's like I said, 6 rounds. I mean, it's up to you. Here's another question. Have you ever experienced civil unrest? Does going to Flint Community Schools count? No, I'm kidding. Okay, and that moves us to this comment, Chanel 4, quote, EMPs, I read somewhere you can use an old microwave to insulate against EMPs. Just store your electronics inside when they are not in use. I don't know. I don't know about the old ones. But I want to do a little experimenting and see what signals will get through and what won't. Alright, here's my cell phone right here. Let's see what happens when I take the aluminum foil and cover it up. See if the signal actually gets through. Ringing on this end. Let's see what happens. Okay, nothing happened. Let's see if there's a missing call. A missed call in here. No missing calls. No missed call, so the signal didn't really get through. Now, it's not really an old one. See if the signal gets through. Got through. All right, let's see what happens when we put it in here. Hear it. Wonder what happens when you use a military surplus can. Clean it out. I'm pretty sure what's gonna happen, but still be worth seeing for myself. Didn't work. I guess the lesson is that you need a cage to be entirely consisted of metal with no openings whatsoever for it to really, really work. You have to completely encase the electronic event from an electromagnetic pulse, something that can be given off by solar activity or by a nuclear weapon in the sky or whatever. But anyway, I want to address the mystery heater question. Some people say it's too difficult to turn on. I want to show you guys just how easy it is to turn on. Okay, some people complained that it was kind of difficult to turn on the Mr. Heater buddy system, and I had a problem to begin with, but once you learn how to turn it on, it's actually pretty easy. First, again, I gotta remind you, you need batteries, and this is the exact type of batteries that you need, okay? Alright, you open up the bay, this is from the side, twist it on, I'm trying to do everything in real time. Okay. You hear the fan going. I like to give it a sec to get going there. And the idea is to turn it on to pilot and get it lit. You push down. Okay, you see this right here? You push down, and you turn to pilot. And you don't let go until you're sure it's on. Didn't work. Try it again. Hold it. Release. Now it's going. The pilot's on. Now let's see if I can actually turn it on to low. Okay, now it's on. What I gotta tell you is when you press down and you turn a little bit, you don't have to press as deep as you had to get the pilot. It's a little light press. Light. Turn up some more. It's a medium. Yep, and I can feel the heat already.